The White House published a report on Friday compiled by hundreds of scientists from across 13 federal agencies. The Climate Science Special Report finds what we thought we knew about global warming was only the tip of the iceberg. Co-author of the study and director of the Texas Tech Climate Center, Katherine Hayhoe, tweets, "Much of what we've learned in recent years suggests changes could be more extensive, more rapid, and more damaging than we previously thought." The special report notes that each of the last 3 years have set temperature highs. It also warns that weather disasters like hurricanes and floods that have cost the U.S. $1.1 trillion since 1980 could become more commonplace if action isn't taken to reduce our emissions. For decades, the fossil fuel industry has been waging a campaign against climate science, just like Big Tobacco did back when researchers first started linking smoking with lung cancer. Some conservatives have finally admitted your eyes are not deceiving you, climate change is real, but we shouldn't do anything about it because it would be too expensive, or we should wait for India to take the lead. There's little reason to think that yet another scientific report will fundamentally change attitudes on global warming, either among policymakers or the public. Researchers have found again and again that attitudes about climate change are shaped far more profoundly by political ideology or by comfort with proposed solutions to global warming than they are by the science itself. The White House immediately issued a statement contradicting the findings of its own report. Scientists are relieved it wasn't suppressed, as was feared when the New York Times first started publishing leaked versions of it in August. Despite the best efforts of what Newsweek is calling the most corrupt administration in U.S. history, the report signals a major policy shift. The only question is when. If you found the information in this video helpful, go ahead and share it with a friend. And don't forget to click on the subscribe button so you can find me again.